This channel is all about using digital fashion design software and digital tools to create a more productive and streamlined workflow and to create effective design communication. So today, I want to talk about six tools that are not only my favorites, but also the ones that I believe are currently most effective when it comes to all aspects of bringing your design from concept to production. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Mikkel Drew Pelham. I talk about digital fashion design software and communication on this channel. So if that's something you're interested in, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell. Now, the designer is truly involved in all aspects of the product development and production processes, but we tend to be more involved in the earlier stages of product development. And the phases involved in that are ideation and concept, design and sketching, presenting your ideas, technical sketching, tech packs, and 3D visualization. And for each of those phases, I use or incorporate digital fashion software to make sure I'm working as efficiently as possible and communicating my vision as clearly as possible. So let's start with ideation. Designers start their season by creating concepts and ideas. And at that point, you don't want to edit yourself. You just want to start pulling ideas and putting them all in one place. And if you've seen this video, you've already seen how awesome Make the Dot is. This is my go-to and favorite tool for starting my ideation journey. I can quickly upload or drag and drop pictures into an endless canvas. They even have a Chrome plugin that will allow you to easily add pictures to boards as you're searching the internet. It also integrates with Pantone, so you can start your color palette and easily match any colors you find in your inspiration photos back to the textile Pantone system. And a newer feature, which I really appreciate, is that you can start some of your fabric sourcing right in the app with their fabric widget that directly connects to fabric stores like Mood, B&J Fabrics, and Queen of Raw. Once I've edited and finalized my concept and color boards, I'm ready to use them to start sketching. The one thing I want to be clear about in this phase is that you're still ideating somewhat, but this time you're ideating on your designs. And because you're usually just trying to get your ideas out of your head and onto paper, you want to make sure you're using software that will allow you to just freehand sketch. This is a great time to use your iPad if you have one, but if you don't, you can use a tablet and stylus on your computer. Otherwise, I definitely recommend that for this stage, you move away from digital and go back to pen and paper. But if you're able to keep it digital, this is when I start using Photoshop and Fresco. Now, Fresco can only be used on a tablet, but you can of course use Photoshop on the desktop as well as your tablet. There are also quite a few users who absolutely love Procreate. I am not a fan, but I've always heard good things about it. So choose what works best for you. When it comes to digital freehand sketching programs, there are quite a few options to choose from. This next one is a newer addition to my workflow because it incorporates AI. And the reason I like it is because it allows you to quickly create some great looking photorealistic images of your designs that you can use to sell your idea to different people, whether it's customers or salespeople on your team. While I love a flat sketch, sometimes people don't really understand the nuances of them, or they can't really get as excited about it. And using Newark.ai has really been helpful to allow me to showcase a more three-dimensional version of my design so that it's more understandable to someone who's not familiar with flat sketches. 3D is also more realistic, so it usually gets people more excited about the product. The last thing about Newark is that it's quicker than building an entire 3D garment in a software like Clo3D or Browseware. That is a step in my process eventually, but I don't want to take the time to do that before I even know if someone's interested in the design at all. Okay, you've got your feedback and you know what styles you're going to move forward with. Now you're ready to create your flats. And no surprise here, my go-to software is Adobe Illustrator. Not only is this software industry standard, but it's one of the best to give you the precision you need to draw an accurate and proportional flat sketch. And once the flat sketch is done, the companion to that is the tech pack, which is the rest of the instruction manual for the manufacturer who's going to make the style. Now, you can use Excel or Google Sheets to create your tech pack, and I even have a free template that you can use. But a much better program for this is TechPacker. From the name, it's pretty obvious what it does. And if you want a crash course in how to use TechPacker to create tech packs, you can check out these videos on my channel. But past the tech pack, one of the most useful things I appreciate about TechPacker is that all of your communication about your style, and there will be quite a bit from questions about fabric, construction, costing, and more, happens right in the app. So you never have to go looking through emails or rifle through papers to find what was last said about the final cost or if the supplier has a fabric. It's all consolidated in one place and it's all connected to that style. That may not seem like a big deal to you, but having worked as a product developer for several years, I can tell you that having everything in one place is not only a time saver, but it also cuts down on mistakes and misinformation. This is also a relatively newer step in my process, but a step that I really appreciate because it lends to me being able to make decisions more quickly, save money on sampling, and also reduce waste. Once the tech pack is complete, I move into 3D visualization. Now, some people will use this tool earlier in the process, and in fact, at one point, I did before I started using Newark. And keep in mind that Newark is not a replacement for 3D software. But if you're still in the ideation phase and haven't quite decided if you even want to move forward with a product, Newark is great because it saves you the time of creating it in 3D, only to drop that style later. Some designers will also create the 3D in lieu of a flat sketch and use the tech pack that's generated in the 3D software. I personally prefer still drawing the flat sketch first because flat sketches give you the opportunity to work out your ideas in terms of construction and finishes. Sometimes you're even still working out the design lines. And for any of these digital fashion software programs, you want to have a plan when you sit down and use them. Remember, these are tools that help you execute your vision. So solidify your vision first and then use the tools to clearly communicate that vision. After that step, someone else in your team, maybe a merchant or a salesperson, takes those digital assets and starts working with them to assort and merchandise your line. You may be working with that person, sometimes you are that person, but you're going through and deciding what styles and colors work together so that your collection looks cohesive. You may also have samples made and wait until you receive the samples to do this process. But if you're using digital tools, I recommend you save your money and try to do your first round of assorting and merchandising digitally so that you only make the styles that you know you're going to carry in your line that season. At the very least, if you still decide to drop styles after the actual samples come in, the number of items that drop should be minimal, which means you're minimizing wasted money and you're reducing excess sampling. Thanks for watching this week's video. I hope it's been helpful in sorting through the many digital fashion design software options that are available and why you might use a particular software. I will leave a link to my free tech pack template in the description. And if you're looking for step-by-step instruction in using Illustrator for fashion design or Clo3D, make sure you also check out the links to my online beginner courses, and those will also be in the description. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share this video if you find it helpful. Have a fantastic week, and I'll see you next time.